hole. McCumber taking no active interest in the proceedings, just staying on the other side of the fairway.
Can you move now, please? Thank you.
You have your time, so you can move now.
Well, it looks as if he's able to get a swing at hit and sort of come out sideways, sort of
please,
short of the road. Really was a poor tee shot. And it could cost him a place in tomorrow's games, because he's 2 or 3 inches off the ground and he's going straight out back down the fairway, so he'll be playing three, but well, McCumber's only played one. Still two holes to go. At worst, he'll be one down, two to play.
Please, you know, the ball can go anywhere, may hit you, it can back in the ditch. Just move on the right side, please. So I don't know which way it will go. Thank you.
Well, he's out and not reached the fairway. So, in technical terms, he's making a real pig's ear of this. And it's still his turn. Oh, dear. But I think with the wind behind and Seve's power, he can crunch this on with an 8 or a 9 or something like that. Strong again, it is. 360 yards, and he's coming straight in at the flag. But don't be at all surprised if he doesn't get down in 2 from here. Hard work he's put in. He was 4 down halfway through the outward 9 this afternoon, and he's battled back and battled back, and suddenly on this quite innocuous hole, an iron from the tee, and he puts it in the bushes. Oh, that was an interesting little shot. That was a strange shot, wasn't it? It was a sort of little pushy pitch and run that went nowhere. Extraordinary now, McCumber. All he has to do is find the green and 2 putt. Seve would have to chip in for a half. Oh, back she go. Well, we've seen people 3 putt from there, so every step of the way there's something going on. So, McCumber will be thinking of all sorts of thoughts. Well, what about that? He said when interviewed by Clive, the clerk of the course at lunchtime, that he was very happy to be 4 up on someone who plays as well as Seve. Now, I wonder if his old heart's going pitter-patter at the moment, I bet you. Oh, Seve is going to chip up from the side of the green. And having watched Seve over the years, you remember, some of you must do, when he was playing Arnold Palmer at the 18th, and Arnold was going to beat him and suddenly hold out from about 40 yards short of the green, and then beat Palmer up the first extra hole. The full facts about this 16th hole is, over all the years that this championship has been played, there have been, and bearing in mind the field has sometimes been much smaller than this, have been on 65 occasions people have taken five here, on four occasions they've taken six or more, and that's quite a lot really. Oh, 69 goes, it's quite a high percentage when you think of the simplicity of the hole, and normally the prevailing wind is helping. So Seve, fourth shot, 16th, match all square against McCumber. It's not a million miles away, is it? Oh, I don't believe it. Oh, Seve, fancy missing. What a delightful shot, though. It's quite extraordinary. You never know what's going to happen. He's like a jack-in-the-box. He's down and here and round. And that's a five. Now, McCumber needs two putts. And I fancy he'll have to put this very close indeed to get a concession. Match play at its best, because I think in medal play he wouldn't be at all concerned about three putting. He'd think, well, I won't three putt from here. Suddenly, under this situation, he'll be thinking all sorts of little things. Just need to roll it up. He'll be thinking of all those old sayings like putt it into a circle. Imagine you, there's a bucket or a water butt sunk in the ground, just roll it up. McCumber, two putts from here to be one up and a couple left to play. Well, almost a wide, but a good pace, and one of them left. Whether he's going to pop this one in. Wondering about the tee shot. Two elementary mistakes. For him, elementary mistakes have been so far expensive, and they could be very expensive, particularly if McCumber, well, he holds this. There's still two holes left to play, two par fives. To win the hole and go one up with two to play. I say, see, a little twitchy, and I think he might be asked to putt the next one. Seve, don't be too kind. Oh, he's giving it to him. Well, I can think of a few that wouldn't have given me that one. And he cracked that in, and Seve escapes. And McCumber shows there is a little weakness there. I think technically there's a little weakness in his swing, and I think over these next couple of holes, I'll be interested to see where he drives, because he's got one of those styles that, when under pressure, he could well hit the ball 30 yards to the right. And so down to the 17th they go, the mat all square.
And 17th, 571 yards. And a great finish for match play golf, these last two holes. If you finish 4-4, you've got a very good chance of winning both of them. If you finish 5-5 equally, you're particularly good, two up and two to play, you would not be surprised if you lose both of them. It's anything can happen. now. He's reached for the driver. We heard Ian Woosnam earlier saying for him this was a 3-wood and a 1-iron. And having tweaked one left at the previous hole, which it's very difficult to put that from your mind and not take some little corrective measure, particularly with this bulging out of bounds coming in on the left-hand side. And he's carved him away. It's, ooh, it is way, way right. There's a car park down there. It's probably okay. There's plenty of ground over there. And he certainly corrected the previous tee shot, but it's, oh, it's such hard work today. It really is. Now, look how much, you know, it aims at that out of bounds and the club head off the ground. There'll be a forward press of the hands. And you perhaps he hits it straight at the out of bounds. It really is, must be very confident in the knowledge. Oh, and well, that's okay, it's on the fairway, but he's got a tricky one. He's going to have to bend it round, and that's not his shape of shot. So that's certainly McCumber is in the better position. It'll be interesting to see whether he has got the right to lefter in his locker. Well, now we'll have a look at Seve's again. Looks okay. Stands slightly open. The head stands still. You can never find really anything wrong. He does pick the club up really rather quickly, breaks the wrist quite quickly, but that looks fine. And you can see the head moving back now there, and that's probably where it comes. He hit it up in the air and away to the right, and the wind's a little bit from left to right as well as behind. And one or two sort of anti-hook mechanisms I felt came in there. And he threw it up in the air, probably hit it higher than he normally would, and the wind and the general direction of the shot carved it away to the right. And I think that was a little movement backwards towards the camera of the head there. Now, the very different style of McCumber. Look how far out to the left he stands. He does the forward press of the hands and then almost immediately starts to break the wrist. The club head, well, it gets well to the horizontal. And he slides everything out of the way, leaps up, clears everything, up comes the head. And he sort of almost chops at the ball to make certain, keeping the hands ahead of the club head until after the ball has been hit, to ensure that it goes from left to right every single time.
Well, for those of you who are just coming in from work and joining us at this point, this is the second day and the second round of the World Match Play Championship, the 25th to be played on the West Course at Wentworth. And this is the situation so far in the play today, with Ian Woosnam of Wales, the defending champion, having beaten Jeff Sluman, the United States PGA champion, 7-6, a very decisive win indeed. And then Nick Fowler of England had a fine 5-4 win over Joey Sindelar of the States, the leading money winner in America this year so far. So that set up a Woosnam-Faldo confrontation in tomorrow's semi-finals. And then Sandy Lyle made a remarkable comeback. Having been 5 down after 3 holes in the afternoon, he came back from 5 down to win 3-2 over Nick Price of Zimbabwe, whose golf towards the end really did slip away from him. So now, the final match, who plays Lyle, Ballesteros, McCumber, all square on the 17th.
Well, so he is right in among the cars there. I can only presume that he's going to get a free drop and he'll come out on the course side. A little consultation here with the referee.
Really? Where is it down here?
Keep going.
Go back a little.
I'm pretty soft on it.
You better come back in here.
Keep going.
Yep. Keep going. Got to hit the corner of the car first.
Long way
in.
They're too far away.
Incredibly good view about it.
Move back, please. Right back.
Oh, Seve's getting a free drop here to... it could easily be a line of sight rule. I wouldn't swear that's right, but the rules of golf are rather complicated. The point really is here where he gets to drop, because there are a few little saplings ahead of him, and this is going to make all the difference in terms of what line he can get at the green. He's about 280, 85 yards away. So, I mean, if he got a very good lie, he's just dropped. I'm just trying to get a look at it. Possible he'll get very near to the green with a good shot from there, but we'll just have to wait and see.
May well be he also damaged his ball when it banged in amongst the cars, and that might have been asking the umpire to change the ball. Now he's got, I mean, certainly that's straight through that gap. He can have a go at the green. And it's funny, this is the fascination of match play. Of course, both these golfers obviously very keen to win and lots of money available, and Seve with tremendous pride, as I'm sure McCumber has as well. But neither of them can really get going at the moment. In fact, it's become a real dogfight, a real scrap. And nonetheless fascinating for all that. Of course, all the dangerous things, he'll need everything in his locker to get to get home from there. And of course, you've got to remember, out of bounds down the left-hand side. And I think discretion the better part of valour. And rely on his usually immaculate short game, which has been a little wayward today. Nothing wrong with the lie. I think this is for safety. Get it down some 20, 30 yards short of the green if he can.
Oh, great shot.
I don't know that that's...
Great shot.
There we got it. Oh, he's all right. You saw him, his body sort of move forward. And all right. But that's 50, 60 yards short. And a difficult pitch downhill. He's there. He's some 10 or 15 feet above the level of the green. And you see the wind, a very strange one. Well, we saw it on the weather forecast, how it's sort of swirling in from the northwest. So it's from left to right as well as behind. So he's there in two. Now McCumber. Well, there's one to bend round the corner.
Yes, he's got about 250, 55 yards to go, and he can aim for the right edge of the green and draw it back. But, you know, when you're trying a specialised shot, so much can go wrong.
Will the people move back where the crossing sign is?
Particularly Clive, of course, when he's, it's not his, it's a complete opposite to the way he normally plays the game.
So, yeah, it's very useful. I mean, all these pros, though, can hit it both ways, but they do tend to have one natural shot.
Certainly a much squarer stance, but I think what I suspect he's done is just hit that straight, as much as he could achieve. The noise from the crowd. Oh. And down there. And so I think of the two, I would prefer, depending on his lie, and that doesn't, looks as though there could be some rough grass behind that ball there. I would prefer Ballesteros' pitch. The pin is cut over the right-hand side of this green, the side that McCumber's ball is, and he's, oh, good, 10 feet below the level of the putting surface there, certainly 8 feet. So much less green to work with than has Seve, of course, who's got all that expanse, some 30 yards of flattish green. And the rain comes down. Spring showers almost.
In fact, Seve hit a 3-iron there for his second shot, and the rule was an immovable obstruction, which means that they come to the point where you get relief, and then he gets one club length from there. So that's a free drop for Seve.
Fair enough. But it'll be Ballesteros, and that's, as I say, a good 60 moves, 70 yards to the pin, and the crowds following this game. The last one out, the last of the four quarterfinals. Stadium golf. Of course, a great time of the year. If you've had a good season, this is the time when you really start to reap the benefit. These speciality events, World Match Play, the Dunhill Cup next week, and a few things around in the Pacific Basin, when you can double, treble your earnings for the year. Nice lie. No problems. She's got to go over a little bank. And easier, I think, almost, than if he was some 30, 40 yards further and just over that little hump that you can see at the left front of the green. And toss this one right up to the pin. He hasn't done it. It would have been a brave shot, and the sort of shot we expect is pretty good. But nothing quite working at the moment for either of them. So McCumber away to the right of the green and the right of your picture. And well, you wouldn't take long, or you wouldn't give many odds against a half in five here. What little we saw of his ball a moment or two ago, I thought it was sort of almost on a little bit of a path, which might make it a very awkward shot indeed. Some rough bank. Down in there. I think the ones on the right, you'll want to move back quite a bit. Yes, you'll have to move back 4 or 5 yards, I would think.
Awkward little shot here from Mark McCumber. He's coming from below the green. It's a very tight lie, it's bare down there. And he hasn't really got very much green to work with. Could possibly be a pitch and run into the bank, but certainly a very difficult shot to get close.
And of course McCumber has just dropped 3 consecutive shots and 4 shots in the last 6 holes, so confidence in any part of his game is a bit down at the moment. It's at times like this when you say, well, now the last thing I must do is not get it on the green. I really must make certain again. And then that suddenly means it's sort of 15 or 20 feet. I can just see the ball. This guy has a bearish lie. He's got a very lofted club.
Can I get you all the back up, please? I don't want to be over here, I promise. I wish I wasn't in your way over here.
But not that lofted now. I think he might well and bop this into the bank and hop it over. Oh, he's played that well. I think from where he was, I think that was perhaps as good as he might have expected. So honours even so far. Nothing much to choose. And whoever comes through this game will breathe a sigh of relief, be delighted he's got through to the semi-finals and probably knock it round in a couple of 66s tomorrow. And Although Seve ought to be feeling the better of the two, having come back from four down with some 12 holes to play, the way he's played several of the last few holes wouldn't have inspired him with confidence. He's not really on a roll. It's more that McCumber's sort of lost holes and he's won them. And these greens, in spite of a lot of rain over the last few days, are still surprisingly quick. They're difficult to read. There's lots of subtle borrows. The ball can roll two or three different directions in the space of 5 or 6 yards. And as we've seen, you can't afford to rush the ball, rush them at the hole. Now, this is what I was saying at the 15th. This is what he does. He has the putt held in very, with the pin held in very close to it. It's right on line. But they do, the ball, as it starts to lose strength, does move very violently right and left. So a 5 has been conceded. And once again, McCumber has a putt. That were he to hole it would give him the lead going into the last hole. It's interesting, the winning scores have sort of gone in descending order. Woosnam was 7 and 6, then 5 and 4, Lyle 3 and 2, and one hole would have a nice mathematical progression. There'll be a lot of practice after this round's over for whoever wins. So McCumber has this for a 4 and a win. No. Ooh, he hardly seemed to touch that. So the hole is halved in 5 and they come, go to the last, the 18th, all square. And neither player exuding any confidence at all. But that's the fascination of match play. And great fun, all to play for.
Well, this is the sort of stuff people come to see at the World Match Play, and every year it provides something like this. So the semi-final opponent for Sandy Lyle tomorrow is still not decided. Ballesteros and McCumber go down the 36th hole, all square.
And there's the 18th hole, and I wonder if it's going to be the final one of the day. 502 yards, par 5, it'll be Seve with the honour. And he had the honour the last couple of holes, and he's played 2 poor tee shots, and they both cost him 5s. One was a par, one was a drop shot, the short 16th. So, in all truth, either of them might well have won this match by now. But Seve has come back, McCumber having been, well, he was 4 up, standing on the 8th tee, on the 7th tee this afternoon, and now the match is all square. And I think it's very important here that Ballesteros gets a good drive away so that he can reach the green with a 2 or a 3 iron. For both these players who hit the ball far enough, or more than far enough, they can both reach the green in 2 if they get a good tee shot away. Seve's chattering away. He's coming through here and there's no better man. He looks. Okay. And a good welcome.
It's on the club, is it?
And they seem very relaxed, these two. Ballesteros will. Most of the players have teed up on this side because of the wind and the way the hole swings round the corner. And it would be, it would be criminal to lose this hole to a par 5. So a drive, very important. one place he, one thing he doesn't want to do is hit the same tee shot he did at the last hole. A bit left. Well, ooh, I say, if that's his tee shot, that's a monster shot. That may not be a ball, that may be a bit of paper or something there. And now, McCumber. There's McCumber's centre of the fairway, and Ballesteros, is that Ballesteros' ball down the hill just off the fairway? That's McCumber, who's quite a way back, and Ballesteros is, there's the lady marker going, and my word, it was Seve's drive. Now he's on the downslope. Now there was somebody there earlier today. Sandy was down there. Sandy Lyle hit a huge drive. And the flag is on the front of the green. Seve's got to come in over the bunker. So he's got a much shorter shot. McCumber, though, has a good shot into the green. Is Seve's swing, which is now very familiar. It's very wide. Hands look a fraction lower than normal, but the head, as usual, remains very still. The legs work well. Lovely position at the top of the backswing. Left heel down, and the legs drive on. Club head thrown past the chin. And he gets well through that one. A nice high finish. And this has been very untidy. Whoever wins this will really have nothing to boast to the grandchildren about, because McCumber needs a, if he gets a par here, he'll be around in 78. And Seve was 36, one over. Seve wants a four for 73. He took 73 this morning. So that's really not very good by their high standards. And McCumber hasn't managed a birdie at all this afternoon. Seve's only had two, and when you compare that to Sandy Lyle, even Joey Sindelar had a couple of birdies, Sluman had three, Woosnam's had a bunch of them today. So this has been an exciting match, but a bit untidy.
Mark McCumber with 245 yards to go. He may try and run it onto the green with a long iron, or he might even go for the forward and try and carry it most of the way. Seve, some 35 yards ahead of him, 210 to go. He's in a very similar position to where we saw Sandy Lyle this morning, but in fact he's got a better lie. There's a little depression there in that slope, and it's not quite as bad as the slope might indicate in terms of the lie running away from him. So Seve downwind, and I would think he'll probably get home with something like a 5-iron from there.
Well, players just
can you stand surrounded
by
the
spectators. We may have to get a steward or two on out on the course tomorrow. See, they're crowding in on the corner. Of course, if this hole is halved, it'll be sudden death. Starting off up the first.
Thank you. Right to left, Pat.
McCumber, you can see the flag just to the right of the bunker in the distance. Well, seemed to make a very nice contact. Oh, well done. Very nicely played. And Seve, as Clive was saying, some 30, 40 yards ahead. On the slight downslope, to come in over the bunker.
Yeah, right to left.
Huh? Now, right Seve to has left. Never dropped a stroke on this final hole. It's been one of his favourites, and in fact, he's taking a 5-iron. And you can see he's on that sort of flat little ledge.
Yeah. Sure, it's not too much clap.
Ah, that's the flags blowing. The wind is helping slightly.
How far is to the front?
It's 158 to the front. Normally you hit, what, 165. So no, you've got to carry it over the track, which is four. So it's 160.
I got it right.
Yeah?
Well, Seve said I got the right club, 160 yards to carry the bunker. And he did have the right club for distance. And there they are, side by side, just didn't turn in. There they are, this is good stuff. Jolly good stuff. Most of the, most if not all the spectators have been here today are now gathered around this 18th green. Always have the greatest admiration for people that actually come and pay and walk around watching golf. I can't think of more than, really, if one is brutally honest, more than half a dozen golf courses in the world where watching golf is a real pleasure, a physical pleasure. Usually it's uphill and downhill. Very few courses have simple, good viewing areas to watch from. They enjoy their golf. Rather like Phyllis Court at Henley. Now, they've both got similar putts. Whoever's going to have a go first might well give the other some assistance. And I think perhaps both of them, if they were honest, would settle for two putts now and go into extra time. This isn't an easy putt. We saw a couple from here this morning. Nick Faldo, I think to remember, rolled one down. Nick Price certainly did, rolled one to within a foot of the hole. Very easy to charge it 4 or 5 feet past here. Or knowing or feeling how fast the putt is, leave it equally short. And you can see the swirling wind. If you look behind McCumber, can you see those leaves going round like puppies chasing their own tail? Then suddenly it stops and the wind picks up again. And it's Seve first. Well, are you calling the referee in? Now, is this to decide whose putt it is or what? And have a look at the maybe a damaged hole or whose putt is it or have a look in there, John. What do you make of that? Oh, how old is it? Was a handful of leaves or a dead frog or something, but they obviously didn't want to dirty their hands or whatever was in the hole. Poor old John. Maybe you wash your hands before supper tonight. John Parrymore, Norrie's lad. I must say this match is being played in a joyous spirit. Even the referees and players all actually speaking to each other in a civilized way, which is rather pleasant. And after all that, I'm still not convinced whose putt it is. Now it looks as if it might be McCumber to putt first. I think we might be here for a bit if they're going to wait for all the leaves to clear away. Right, just in time for the PGA Championship next year. Either of them rushing to get the job done or even started. Ah. So McCumber it is. Oh. There might be a few more of them.
Walk in there and get it. Thank you. All right. Now we can go.
McCumber for a three. An eagle three at the 18th. Match all square. Oh, it's racing on. Oh, well, stopped just a yard by. Yard, isn't it? If you follow the folklore of golf, you'd say that Ballesteros is sort of odds-on favourite here. He won the first hole this morning, lost second. He hasn't had his nose in front at any time, any other time during the match. And how often in match play situations, you know, the only time the player who wins is ahead when they come off the last green. So he might well frighten the hole with this. He's left it short. Got the line, forgot to hit it. Conceded. Has he conceded? Oh, they're both conceded. It looks like he's striding off. Well, now. And so off they go into extra holes.
Well, they have a little way to go now to get to the first to start the playoff, sudden death. So while they do, let's just recap on what's been happening today. The first match out today between Ian Woosnam, the defending champion, and Jeff Sluman. This morning, Woosnam lost the first hole, won the second, and was never down again in the morning. He had seven birdies, including fours on the 17th and 18th. He was round in 69, Sluman in 71. So Woosnam went into lunch three up. He went four up at the first in the afternoon. He was five up with a two at the fifth. Sluman got it back to four at the turn, but Woosnam shut him out by winning the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th, 7 and 6. And then Nick Faldo playing against Joey Sindelar. Well, only one up after the first 11 holes, but birdie four on the 12th and a par five on the 15th sent Faldo into lunch. Three up with a 70 against Sindelar's 73. And Nick started with a birdie three in the afternoon and an eagle three at the fourth. He was now five up. But Sindelar won the eighth and the ninth to turn three down, and it stayed like that until the 13th when par four, put him four up with four to play, and then Nick's three at the short 14th from the back of the green was enough for him to win 5-4. And the other match, Sandy Lyle and Nick Price. Well, Price had three birdies in a row this morning at the 7th, the 8th and the 9th. So he turned two up, and then Sandy won the next two to go all square. It went up and down for a bit until Price won the 15th and the 16th with par fours. They were good enough, and Price was running 68 to go into lunch two up. Price won the first three holes of the afternoon, and all with pars. Sandy was not playing well, and so now Price was five up and Lyle in distinct trouble. But Sandy then won the 4th, the 6th, the 7th and the 9th, including two birdies to get back to only one down. He won the 10th with a birdie 2 to go all square. He was up and running now. He won the 12th, the 13th and the 15th to go 3 up, and a birdie 3 at the 16th shut out Nick Price 3-2. Now they've reached the first in the playoff.
So Ballesteros still with the honour, and the last hole he won was the 15th, where McCumber dropped one of the several shots he's dropped over the closing holes. This opening hole, first time we've seen it, 471 yards, very tough hole. It's back into the wind, all the wind has died a little bit this evening. You drive onto a big top plateau of a fairway. The left-hand side is preferable to the right, I think. It then drops down through a very deep valley and then up again to the green, which is on very much the same sort of level as the fairway. Two good blows, and as Nick Faldo was saying earlier, you can't get on. Well, he couldn't get on this morning or earlier this afternoon with a drive and a one iron. He may fiddle around a lot, but once he actually takes up his address position, he hits it very quickly indeed, and well, that's what I would call the wrong side of the fairway, and it's in the rough. They can't see those golfers crossing the fairway, they're down in the valley. Now McCumber. Watch the forward press of the hands from here. And that two fading left to right, but on the fairway. So that's the better of those two. Peter, it's fun really, isn't it, with a game. I mean, they haven't played very good golf, but it's been fascinating for all that.
Yes, that's match play, and why so many people enjoy watching it, and perhaps the players don't enjoy doing it, because everything is so sudden. But you know, everything is, you've won or you've lost, or you're packing your bag and going home. And it's one of the few times in golf that people can play scrappily, but it's still a good match. And this has been a classic example of that. Seve must be the most exciting player in the world to watch, alongside perhaps with Greg Norman. Exciting, that means, you know, like Arnold Palmer was exciting, and Jack Nicklaus perhaps wasn't as exciting. McCumber, more of a plodder, more of a good plodding professional, and there have been many more of them than there have of the Palmers and Ballesteroses. It has been an untidy match scoring wise, but and yet still the adrenaline's been flowing, and you know, they'll play this, so they're playing 1, 2, 17 and 18. Then they'll keep going around in a circuit until somebody wins a hole. And you would have to, I think, go with Seve at this time because of his experience and his flair. McCumber appears to be struggling. Well, he is struggling. He's around in 77. Seve around in 73. 273s today, which not good for him. He's got the longer tee shot here. If he's got a reasonable lie, he might be able to lash it up on the green. He's had his opportunities and not taken them. Clive's scampering about out there. Clive, can he reach from there?
Yes, I think he can reach. He's got maybe just over 230 yards to go, but the wind is straight against, judging by the clouds. But of course, down here at player level, it swirls about in the trees, and a few minutes ago it felt like it was coming from the left, and now it's changed if it's coming from the right. Once the ball gets above the tree line, it'll certainly be straight into the wind. I think really the decision here is what he plays, whether he can get home with a 1 iron. I don't know. It's a very big hit. Nick Faldo told us that he didn't get home earlier this afternoon with a drive and a 1 iron.
Very what about McCumber, Clive?
What
about McCumber? Can he reach?
Yeah, well, they're both... he's only about 3 or 4 yards nearer.
From our angle here, it looks as if he's 20 yards or more behind.
And I see Seve's taken a wood out. So it looks as if that's going to be the three wood.
And who's to terrific play first?
Seve first. Terrific galleries around here, though. You know, the feeling really is electric down here.
And it's the three wood. Now he started it left and he's cut it. Has he overdone it? A bit of clapping. Oh, and that's wild. We haven't seen a shot of that caliber in the last hour in this match. Suddenly the green has disappeared for Mr. McCumber, I suspect. He's tried to follow exactly the same route, come through the same bit of sky, but couldn't quite hit it far enough. Advantage Ballesteros.
Yeah, there's still quite a lot of golf to be played here yet, because there are so many permutations. But seeing that shot from Seve can remind you of so many other instances in sport where, you know, a first division football club playing someone from the third division south or Yeovil Town, and they struggle and the weaker team have their chances and can't take them, and then suddenly the big boys pounce. I suppose it's the same at cricket, dropped in the slips off the third ball of the day and going on to make a glorious 100. And Seve, in all truth, hasn't played really much of his game today, but he's played the good shot when needed and hold the crucial putt, and you know, just to keep going. And then when asked the question here, he's played, I would say that's the shot of the day for him, a majestic shot.
Yes, Peter, I mean, the shot of the day from anyone, I think. And of course, what has been interesting, he's played such fabulous golf for the last couple of months since he won the Open. It's not surprising that perhaps, like, you know, a good racehorse, any good sporting animal, you know, he's slightly lost his game, lost a little bit of its condition.
Well, he looks a bit weary, doesn't he, again? I mean, do I detect slight bags under the eyes there, which he looks a bit drawn and a little weary. And as you say, he's been pounding the fairways for the last couple of months in tremendous style. And it's very punishing. It doesn't appear to the uninitiated that golf is a punishing game, but you get very mentally tired. And Seve's, what is he, 31? Which isn't as old as Methuselah, but he's been around for 12 years or more. It takes its toll. That really was a super shot, but he's got an awkward putt of about 12 or 14 feet. It looks shorter, but I'm sure it's about 14 feet. And McCumber's got a task to get down in two. He's got a long, must be all of 25 yards. It's looks about that. It might be a little less, but it's certainly cricket pitch length, with a big swing from right to left as he comes up the green. And if he gets this within 3 or 4 feet, he'll have done very well. And it'll be interesting to see whether he puts it, whether he plays a 6 or 7 iron run, or whether he plays it with a 9 iron, closing the face and squirting it along the ground. I think it's probably odds on the putter, but all depends how you see the shot at that moment. Looks as if he's going to putt it the way he's clearing all those little bits of debris out the way. Yes, McCumber's going to putt. Well, he said this morning his long putting had been very good. It needs to be now. Too low. It was always coming down below the hole, and you see he's gone on 4 or 5 feet past. Now he's got the left to righter coming back up. Now Seve's putt from 14 or 15 feet will be just outside the right edge, but speed so important again. The winner here will play Sandy Lyle tomorrow morning. It'll be Woosnam against Felder. Oh, this is it. This for the match. He's hit it. It's there. Well, what a way to go. Oh, and he knows it. It's been a titanic struggle for him today. McCumber had his chances. And he said, do you want to buy a putter? But it's just been one of those days, and Seve's played well when it mattered. Ooh, and suddenly he looks a little bit younger, and Mr. Lyle is waiting for him in the morning, and that promises again to be a cracking game. And we've got, isn't it funny again how we've followed this event now, this is the 25th year, and we wondered and wondered and wondered when we would have a homegrown player winning it. And that only happened, what, last year? We've had them in the final, and now suddenly we've got four Europeans in the semi-finals. Three homegrowns and Seve.
Seve, that's what I call a tough match.
Yeah, it was very tough all the way, and I think he was on Mark's hands all the way, and I feel I didn't play well, and I think he didn't play very well on the backside either. So it wasn't much fun out there, but it was difficult. You know, it's a lot of wind and it's cold, and it's very difficult to, you know, to have the feel with the club. It's very difficult.
I'm sure it is. You were four down, and you got back to square after 15. 16 was an interesting half.
Yeah, well, I make a very bad swing from the tee. You know, I take the club a little bit off the line, outside, upright, and I pull it to the left into the trees, and you know, so I chip back into the rough, still in the rough, and then short. But as you know, in match play, I knew the ping was on the very back, and I knew he was going to play short, his second shot, you know, to play safe. He didn't need to attack the ping on the 16, and I knew that from the front part of the green, it was very easy to three putts. So, you know, I concentrated on my chip, and I hit a good chip, close, and he made three putts, and I was lucky enough.
And a birdie three at this first hole, particularly today, with the wind against, is quite something. I mean, I remember Gary Player saying he's played so many times here, he's only ever made one birdie on this hole.
Well, I think today, probably this, the first hole is the toughest, I think, and I hit a big drive and a very big three wood, and I was lucky enough to be 10 feet away and hold the putt. That's probably the only good hole I played today.
Nice little touch at the 15th. That young man was trying to take your photograph.
Well, he was ready to take a picture, and you know, and I was over the ball, so I said, well, take one and just put it in the pocket.
Good. Well, it's been very exciting watching you play, Seve. What are your thoughts for the rest of the event?
Well, I think I have to improve my game. I didn't play very well today. I think I face tomorrow, I think, who will I face? Sandy Lyle?
You play Sandy tomorrow.
Sandy Lyle. Sandy's, you know, is very good player, and he knows the course very well too, and he's very powerful. I think I need to play a little better than I did today, otherwise I have a very small chance.
Well, I think it's going to be quite a match. Yeah. Do you actually like match play?
When I win, yes.
That's rather often,
well,
though.
Well, the match play is different. The only good thing about match play is that you don't have to be worried about keeping the score, which is the thing that we are all year round very worried about, that, you know. And as soon as you don't have to be worried about keeping the score, you play more free, you open yourself more, and you hit the putts more firm, and you're attacking the course more.
So you're more aggressive altogether?
Yes. Mm. I think match play is good for the people to watch, I think. It's better.
Conditions looked a bit harder this afternoon.
Yes, very hard, very cold. I played this course for 13 years, and I never see so much wind. It's a hurricane, even. It was unbelievable.
Well, maybe it'll be a nice sunny day tomorrow.
I hope so.
Good luck.
Like in Spain.
Thank you.
The most popular man in the place, Seve Ballesteros, giving us one of those extraordinary finishes that only he seems capable of.
And now, two up on Seve Ballesteros. Let's bring you right up to date now with Harry Carpenter.
Yes, we're going to show you some of the afternoon play this morning.